Hello, in this tutorial we will learn about the security module options and the updates made in version 9.10. With the Scriptcase security module, we want access control with restrictions according to users, applications or system groups as an example. I will create a security module within an existing project. I created some example applications here, and I will now go ahead and apply the new security module. Now, the security module has been completely redesigned with a new interface and the option to choose your profiles. I will start by creating a new security module. We have various types of security available, and there are in total really three of those. With the new interface in 9.10, we have the user security types more in view. Here you can see the four types, or really three, by group, where you can give permission on a user by group access. You would use this, for example, if you would be in a company where you could create a group by department and group the users within the group, so all the permissions will be according to the group and the application option you will use. Now with 9.10, instead of the independent users group, you now can give access permissions to each of the applications in the system. Then with 9.10, you can also register user by user in the user only option, which has complete validation on the login screen. Then we also have the LDAP authentication options. Here I will choose the group security option, and then here I will choose the connection which I will use for the security database. There are some slight differences with the interface, but otherwise the majority of the options are still the same. On our connection screen, we can choose to first select the connection that we are using if it is not already defined. Then we can choose to use the pre-existing tables that we may already have within our database, or we can create new tables. Below that, we have here our table prefix, as well as then the option to delete tables if they already exist and to protect logged users, or also to use social networks such as Google and Facebook to log in to your platform. Clicking the next button, we can continue to the next screen. We now have all of the configuration options that are available here within the configuration screens available within the backend deployed platform. So when you log in to your portal or platform that you have developed within Scriptcase, you will also see the majority of these settings. We have here on the General tab, first of all, the application prefix. Below that, we have the option to enable security on our existing applications. We can also specify the cookie expiration time, which is by default 30 days. Below that, we have then the theme. Here we can choose any of the themes that are already available within the project. Below that, we have the option to create a new menu if no pre-existing menu is available. In such a case, a new menu will be created with all of the security links. If a menu already exists, then the menu will be selectable and those existing links will not be affected by the insert update of the security applications and links within the old menu. Below that, we can set here the menu theme. There are multiple themes available for the menu, which are also fully compatible with those available within Scriptcase. To the right of our prefix applications, we can specify the folder in which the applications generated will be placed. That is the folder here within our Scriptcase environment. Below that, we can choose to give the user the option to remember their login. On the login page, you will then have the option to remember my login. Then on future accesses to the page or the portal, the user will be automatically logged in during their cookie time. The session expiration time allows us to provide multiple options. Here, you can specify no action at all, so nothing will happen when the session expires. Or you may want to redirect your user to the login page or display them a friendly message and then redirect them to the login page. Below that, you can enable the security log if there has been one generated or created for your platform. If so, then you will be able to select it here, and the security platform will then use that logging system for any portal events that you have specified within the logging system. Below the log system, we can choose the menu orientation. So we can already pre-configure our new menu system before we generate it. Here we can choose horizontal or vertical for the new menu that is created. We can also choose to use suite alerts for the menu system and security applications. The next tab is login. Here within the login tab, we can first specify the label position as above, below, or as a watermark within the field. We can now also, with version 9.10 of Scriptcase, allow the user to log in with their username, with their email address, or their username and email address, or should I say, or. Next to the login mode, we have the encryption options. Do be sure to specify your encryption or add your own encryption to the login password. Selecting the encryption here will apply the encryption method to the security password of your applications. To the right of that, we can give the user the option to view the password characters. On the login page, we will have an eye which we will click. We can see those features shortly. Below the login options, we have then the option to set capture or use capture. Here we can specify no for capture and recapture. API keys may be required. If selected, the secret key and site key will become available, and there you will be able to enter those specific details. Below that, we have the last password change, and this is again one of the new features in 9.10 of Scriptcase. We can specify how often the password should be changed. We can specify the password strength to include capital letters, lowercase letters, numbers, as well as special characters, enforcing a better and secure password authentication for our users. To the right of that, you can display the language selection and login for users on the login page. To the bottom, we can then specify our login fields. We have here the minimum and maximum size of the login field, and to the right, the minimum and maximum size of our password field. And at the bottom, we can choose to use a template for the login screen, which I think I will do. Here, by clicking on the edit pen, I can access the external libraries. Here in Scriptcase, we have the samples library, which I can use and save for my project, which I will also go ahead and do. Once I have saved that as a library within my project, I can choose to use that library and then also to save the project library files. Now returning back to the security and clicking the refresh button, I now have all of the forms and login forms which have been created or that are available within the external library. I can then choose one, and that will then be used for the security generation. The next tab we have is email settings. Within the email settings, which are now also, since 9.10, fully customizable within the back end of the developed generated applications. Here we can also specify the API or add APIs that we have available here within our environment. With a library pre-configured, we can then also return to our security configuration, click the refresh button, and then the API will become available to us. Alternatively, if existing APIs are available, then all you need to do is check here the enabled button, and then again return to security, refresh, and then also that menu, that API option will also become available to you within the project. With the email settings defined, we can continue to the next tab, users. With 9.10, all of these options that we have available here are available within the backend for later configuration. Here we can specify for new users if we allow registration of new users on the login page. This will present users with the option to create a new user account on the login page. Below that, we have the option to require activation by email. On successful registration, the user will receive an activation email. They must click the link and activate their account. The next option is to send email to administrator. Enabling this will notify the administrator of any new users created within the platform. To the right of that, we have the options for retrieving passwords. We can send an email by password, we can reset a password and send a new one by email, or we can send an email link and giving the user the option to set a new password on your platform. At the bottom, we can then change the default group. At the moment, group default is specified. Let me indicate here users for user accounts. Next tab, we have authentication. And with 9.10, we can now also specify the two-factor authentication, whether it is disabled, Google authentication, SMS, email, but now also the operation mode as individual or everyone. As an individual, each user will be given the option to enable two-factor authentication on your platform. Choosing everyone will enforce two-factor authentication for all users on your developed platform. Do be sure to also choose the API that you have configured for that. The method of selection is the same as the previous APIs we have indicated, as well as the libraries. The next tab is insert data. Here we want to adjust the login username and password of the administrator account. Do be sure to not leave this as admin. We then also have the administrator name, as well as the group which administrators will be assigned to. Below the password field, we also have here the email for the admin account. It is very important that you have a functional email account available here. Otherwise, notifications and password resets will not be sent or received to the correct account. The final tab we have available is add applications. Also now with 9.10 of Scriptcase, we can choose if you want to include all applications or selected applications within your security. Choosing that option, you can then simply choose the applications that you want to enable security on, individually, all of them, or none of them. And when you're ready, just click the import button. Once you have configured all of the options within the security module, you can go ahead and click the generate security button. Of course, do note, now with 9.10 of Scriptcase, you are able to configure the majority of those settings that you have just configured for the security generation also within the back end of your completed platform. Before we finish up, there is also a new interface for the save profile. I can choose to save this group security that I have just configured and store it as public, private, or within my user level. And this will then allow me to access that security and very quickly regenerate the security without having to go through any of the settings we have just gone through. Once you click the generate button, your security applications will be generated by Scriptcase. With the applications created, we can then go ahead and generate the source code and ensure that all applications have now been updated and also generated. And then when you're ready, you can go ahead and click the run button. And then with our new login page, which we now have with version 9.10 of Scriptcase, you also now have the language selection available on the login page. If I log in then as admin, I can then sign into security. And then from here, we can see that we have the new menu all filled in with our login details. as well as each of our applications available to us for full configuration of our Scriptcase applications. And do notice in the new security options that we have here all of the password strength options, password recovery, brute force, new user options, email, and of course the general options where we can display as well as remove here the language selection as well as the login mode for users. And also of course note here on the security tab we have here the option to enable the two-factor authentication where we can also make those adjustments which we had available to us within the back end of Scriptcase. So now with version 9.10 of the security module created within Scriptcase, it is near complete. And with all of these new options and the new menus and validations and so forth added within the new security module, we do hope that you like the new features that are now included within version 9.10. And thank you for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.